Hello friends and welcome back to another Pokemon guide here on the channel. My name is Lee, also known as Osiris, and in today's episode I'm going to show you how to get the Swords of Justice, the Musketeer Trio, Terrakion, COBALION, VIRIZION and Keldeo in Pokemon the Crown Tundra. So before we get into this, if you do enjoy this sort of content and find it useful, please drop a like down on the video. It really does help out the channel and the videos themselves. And if you're enjoying this content and all of our Crown Tundra coverage, do consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this and other Pokemon content that we do here on the channel. And lastly, before we head into the guide, do let me know down in the comment section below which one of the Swords of Justice is your favorite. Now, I've got to say, Keldeo is definitely my favorite. It's been probably one of my favorite mythicals of all time. So I'm so happy that we finally have a game where we can actually catch it in without it being an event-only distribution. So let's get into today's guide. Now, this mini quest initiates when you exit Peony's house and discover a set of footprints by a tree. This will trigger Sonia to appear in game, and she will then inform you about the footprints and her research into the Crown Tundra area and the legendaries that are associated with it. She will then go into a house that she's staying in, Freezington, and if you go to the house, she'll further explain this mini side quest. She's investigating these footprints and needs more of them to complete her research and be able to locate these legendary Pokemon. So to do this, what you're going to have to do is head around the Crown Tundra area and locate many footprints. You're going to need 50 footprints from each of the legendary Musketeers, and I say you need to find 50 footprints from each of these Pokemon, as you need to require 100% research done for Sonia's project, and each footprint gives 2% in this research. So that would make sense that you need to find 50. Now, there are going to be more than 50 footprints located in throughout these areas, but you only need to find 50 of them. Once you do find the 50, the other remaining footprints do disappear, and these are all located in set areas within the Crown Tundra. So first off, we will go to Dynatree Hill. Now, when you are here, you're going to be able to find footprints that are associated with Terrakion. You can find them around the tree area, you can find them around the paths and open areas and edges of paths, and in the cave systems as well. You'll locate them everywhere, and they will be clustered together. So when you find one, there's normally two or three alongside that. Now, you just want to travel around this whole area, kind of scour it, make sure you're keeping an eye on the ground, and you'll be able to find these. So you can see now that after a little while, we were able to find the 50th Terrakion set of footprints, and that completes the 100% required by Sonia for her to locate it. But we can't go back to her yet. We need to find the other two prior to going after Terrakion. Now, the second Musketeer that we are going to search for is in the 3-point pass. So you will need to come up to the 3-point pass here, and this is where we're going to find footprints associated with COBALION. Much like our hunt for the Terrakion footprints, we're going to have to explore the cave systems, the beach or the snowy beach area, and then this landmass just off the coast here where you'll find additional footprints for COBALION. Again, we're going to just be searching around the area until we find 50 of those, and once we do that, we'll 100% complete this section of this mini quest. Then finally, the final section is going to be finding Virizion's footprints, which are all located around the Giant's Bed area. Now, the Giant's Bed is a much bigger area than the previous two, and I found it very difficult finding the Virizion footprints. I don't think some of you will. Whether or not I'm colorblind, I don't know, but I found it very difficult to associate the footprints and kind of distinguish them from the grass areas where they're located. Now, I found it easier just running around on foot rather than the bike there. I found on the bike I was missing a lot of them, but after a little while I did manage to find the Virizion footprints. And like I mentioned with the other footprints, when you find one, there's normally a cluster of them together, so you'll be able to find a few at a time. Now, when you've got 100% complete of all of these footprints for Terrakion, COBALION and Virizion, you want to then go back to Freezington and pay Sonia a visit. She'll inform you about the mission and her research, and the 100% complete, she is now able to identify the exact locations of these roaming legendaries. So the first legendary that we're going to go after is going to be in the Giant's Bed, and we're starting at Peony's house. So I'm going to show you, for the sake of this guide, how to get there. You want to exit to the left of this area here, and you want to just make your way out into the main body of the giant's bed and try and avoid all these spawning Pokemon at the same time. And one thing to keep in mind is that the Musketeers, the Swords of Justice, however you want to call them, they aren't shiny locked. So Virizion, Terrakion, and COBALION are not shiny locked. So when they do appear in your game, if you want to shiny hunt for these Pokemon, you're going to be able to do that. Now you want to keep on the main path of the giant's bed, and you want to be heading towards the old cemetery. But it's just before you get to the old cemetery, there will be a clearing in the grass where you're going to be able to find Virizion. And as you can see, Virizion just pops up here. So maybe worth saving your game before you get into the battle with Virizion if you are planning on shiny hunting it. And if you... And once you initiate the battle, you just soft reset. So it's just soft resetting, shiny hunting. It's going to be a bit of a grind, but it will be worth it if you are able to get it shiny. Now moving on to our next Swords of Justice Pokemon, we want to be heading out to the 3-point pass, and this is where we're going to be able to find COBALION. So COBALION is located, if once you're here at the Reggie Temple, you want to just make your way down to the beach area, or this kind of sandy, snowy beach area, and you want to head out to this landmass over here, and this is where COBALION will be located on this island. So it will only take you a moment to get there. And watch out for the square blocks appearing like that. It is an Avalug. It is not a platform that you can just stand upon, which I've been caught out with before. And as you come up to this area, COBALION should just pop up, and there we go. So again, if you're wanting to shiny hunt these Pokemon, you can do. You will just need to save your game before going into this battle. And just to note as well, if you do knock them out by some chance or whatever happens, then don't worry about it, they will respawn. You just need to fly back into the area and that should do the trick for them to reappear. Now we are going to just try and catch this one, see if we can get it pretty quick, and then we'll be right back when we've got it. And we finally get COBALION. So that is two of the Swords of Justice down and one to go in Terrakion, or two to go for Captain Keldeo as well. So we will move on to getting Terrakion, and Terrakion is obviously located where the Terrakion footprints were located earlier on, and we were hunting for those. So what we need to do is head back down to the Dina Tree Hill, or Dana, whatever. And what you want to do is make your way over to the, is it the Lakeside Cavern, I think? And I'm not sure if it's a Lakeside Cavern or if I'm mistaken. Lakeside Cave. Okay. We nearly get it right. And this is where Terrakion will be located. Again, it can be obtained in a shiny form. You want to head over to this area and it will just spawn. So save before it and then just jump into the match and you'll be able to get Terrakion. So we will be right back after we catch this Terrakion. And we finally got it. We finally got it. Wow, that took forever. And I've been teased about 50 times with three shakes. Literally, that took about 60-ish balls to get. But we finally got Terrakion. It is our final one of the legendary Swords of Justice. And what we need to do now, once you've got all three, the next step is to revisit Sonya in her house. And once you do that, we will show you how what happens next, because the next part is very exciting. We need to come back to Freezington. This is where she's located. This is where we were earlier when we were finding out about her research. She is in this house right here, and we want to just head inside. And once we're inside, we want to just talk to her, because she will inform us that we've obviously got 100% of each one of these research methods. She'll give us some prizes. Well, I mean, rewards, prizes. They're not really rewards or prizes. 10 small candies for COBALION. Then we'll get, I think, 10 medium candies for one of the other ones. And then we'll get 10 large candies. I mean, we could get a little bit of a better prize, really, if I'm being honest about it, because at this point in the game, I mean, these candies are really I mean, who hasn't got a bunch of candies just at the disposal? But I mean, it's better than nothing, I guess, Gonna be nice to get like a nice t-shirt or something, I guess, for us, but never mind. Anyway, she just tells us that her research is now complete, and that is her and Yampa, and that is it. They actually just leave, so that is it, and no more Sonya. She has left the Crown Tundra, and that is her research now complete. So this leads us on to our next stage in the quest, because we are now able to go and hunt for Keldeo, which, like I said earlier, Keldeo is, it's the first time Keldeo has been available to catch in a game without any sort of event happening, or event distribution. So what you want to do is come to, I haven't even said where we're going. This would be helpful for the guide. We are heading to the Dino Tree Hill, where we caught Terrakion earlier. You want to head around the hill, down this ramp, and onto this patch of water, and there will be a land mass, or a little island, in this kind of moat region around the tree that you want to head to. And there's some indicators here to how to get the Keldeo. You want to head down to this portion of the island where there is a cooking pot, and you need to have all three of the Swords of Justice in your party. So Virizion, Cobalion, and Terrakion. They all need to be in your party. Now, the previous three were all not shiny locked, so you could hunt for those shinies in Virizion, Cobalion, and Terrakion. But unfortunately, for some reason, they have shiny locked Keldeo. So whatever you do, you may as well just catch it here, unless you want a certain IV spread. It's not going to make a difference. You can mint it, and you can also super hyper train it as well if you want afterwards. So what you want to do when you are here is just set up camp, and you want to create a curry with your three musketeers. So there's Cobalion, Virizion, and there is Terrakion there. And like I say, what you want to do is just start cooking. This little side section here is what you need to do. It's quite a nice little feature here to actually get the Keldeo in game and kind of complete the Justice, Swords of Justice trio. So get some XP there for that, and then we will see Keldeo. We'll just pop up. Will just randomly appear. So like I say, you can save in front of it. Don't worry if you don't and you knock it out. You just need to come and then do the curry thing again on the island and Keldeo pop up. But we are going to go straight for it and try and catch it. And I am so hyped because, like I've mentioned, like out of all of the mythical Pokemon that we've got in all of the Pokemon games, I think Keldeo is definitely one of my favorites. Like, it's such a cool Pokemon. I play VGC quite a lot as well. So, okay, we just missed the knockout there, which is quite good, but ready for us to start throwing some balls at it. Like, I'd love us to have a format where we had mythicals, you know, and we could use things like Keldeo, and Keldeo would be definitely one of the Pokemon I would be using if we could get mythicals. And it's like, yeah, but it's probably never going to happen. Anyway, we will come back after we throw a bunch of Dusk Balls at this thing. And obviously you can catch it in any ball as well if you want to risk it, or just take a little bit longer with it as well. So being not shiny doesn't really make much difference here. So I'll be back when I do eventually catch this Keldeo. Yeah, we got it. Okay, we finally get Keldeo. We've got it in our game now. It is ours. So we've finished and complete the full set of the Swords of Justice, the Musketeer Trio, or Musketeer, however, it's not really a trio anymore, is it? What is it when there's four of them? I have no idea. Okay, so there we go. We've got all of them there, which is obviously the Virizion, the Cobalion, Terrakion. We've all got good speeds as well, except the Virizion, which is not very good. And then the Keldeo as well, which is amazing. So I am really happy with these. Like I say, you can shiny hunt these Pokemon if you want to, but you know, the Keldeo is shiny locked, so just keep that in mind. Don't spend any of your time trying to get it as a shiny. You're not going to be able to. For some reason, Game Freak have locked it out of being a shiny in the games, which is very unfortunate. And that about wraps up the guide for us, my friends. Thank you so much for tuning in to this one today. I really hope it has been useful. If not, I hope it's been entertaining for you at least. And if you are shiny hunting those any of the Terrakion, Cobalion, or Virizion, wish you all the luck in the world. world, because they are going to be very difficult to get, and along the lines of the same for the Regis as well. I'm currently still trying to hunt for Regieleki, so I will update you as soon as I do get that. You can follow me on Twitter, because I'll undoubtedly post a picture of it in all of my joy when I do eventually get it, but it has been a lot of resets so far, and I can see it being a lot of resets in the future. Anyway, talking about Regieleki on a Swords of Justice video. What am I doing? We'll wrap it up there. Thank you so much for tuning in. Like always, if you have enjoyed it, please drop a like. Do subscribe to the channel if you are new and you want to see more of this sort of content. Make sure the notification bell is on, and leave a comment down below. I'm looking forward to seeing which one of the Swords of Justice is your favorite. Obviously, mine is Keldeo, so I'll be looking out for those Keldeo fans as well out there. So, thanks for tuning in, guys. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you all for the next one. So, until then, bye-bye.